Downtown Main Street, it's Disney's House of Mouse.
Who's that knocking at the House of Mouse? We're all knocking at the House of Mouse. Come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're all rocking at the House of Mouse. We're having a ball in the rock of the hall. So come on in,
to the House of Mouse.
The party just started, so come on in. The good times are all just about to begin. Step inside, we're gonna have some fun. We've got plenty of room here for everyone.
The gang's all here and we're hanging out.
All this fun makes you jump and shout. Hey, little girl, I wanna dance with you.
We'll find so many things to do.
So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're having a ball
at the House of Mouse.
Put your hands together for the mouse who made red shorts, yellow shoes, and white gloves a fashion statement, Mickey Mouse!
Thanks a lot. Some crowd! Whoa! I see we have a bear of very little brain in the audience. Ah, just kidding, Winnie. Give that silly old bear some honey. On the house.
Who? Who?
If you haven't heard, our musical guests today are the Three Caballeros, Panchito, José, and who's number three?
Hi, I am.
We took to the streets to find out if anybody knew.
Hit it, Horace.
The Three Caballeros are Panchito, José, and...
Sneezy? No, it's Grumpy. You're so dumb.
The Third Caballero. Now I know there's seven of them.
Who's the Third Caballero?
I know.
Well, there's Cubby, Darlene. I know, Annette.
Is that your final answer?
Who's the Third Caballero? Ha! I don't wonder. I know. It's Simba.
But Timon, I always thought it was Donald Duck.
Quiet, Pumba. I'm trying to score points here.
I still think it's Donald Duck.
I'll give you a hint. Sailor shirt.
Mickey Mouse.
I'm Mickey Mouse.
Hey, you don't wear a sailor shirt.
I can't believe nobody out there knew the Third Caballero is our own Donald Duck.
Donald, wow. I didn't know you were one of the Three Cappuccinos.
Now let's hear it for the Quack Street Boys.
Oh, so dumb. The star of the Three Caballeros.
Are you guys here for the Three Candelabras show? In case you didn't know, I'm dating the Third Candelabra. You know it's Donald Duck, right?
Does he have a sister?
Here's a cartoon starring that favorite Caballero, Donald Duck.
All right, boys, get in line. Last in line as usual, eh, Humphrey? Listen up. As soon as I blow this whistle, it will be time to fish. Laying down on the job again. Humphrey, you're scheduled for winter hibernation tomorrow, so you'd better catch an extra big fish because it's your last meal for a long time and I don't want you eating all my beans again like you did last year. Do I make myself perfectly clear? You better catch a big fish or you'll starve. Good luck.
Oh,
Don't dare instead of your mind like this.
On the guests. Go catch a fish.
Now, where did I put that thing? Oh, here it is. Ah, that's sharp enough.
Oh, soup.
Here's your stick fish. I mean the fish stick, sir.
Ah.
Huh? Sorry, Humphrey, but you know these are bad for you. As for me, I'm already a blob of fat.
Minnie, the Caballeros, are they...
They'll be here in 10.5 minutes.
Here yet?
And they're not our problem, that is.
Donald, you're supposed to be working the door.
The duck formerly known as Donald doesn't do that anymore.
Duck formerly known as Donald? And who are you?
I'm the duck's agent. Anything you have to say to the duck, you can tell me. And I'll tell my agent. We'll run it by our legal team, who will check back in with me, and I'll talk to the duck.
You gotta be kidding.
You see, Mick, may I call you Mick? The duck, formerly known as Donald, realized his role as third Caballero didn't exploit his full star potential.
See you later.
Yeah, a lot later.
Here we go, have a clap. Here's your button.
Blatant merchandising of Donald Duck on this program will not be tolerated.
Ah, but this is the duck formerly known as Donald merchandise.
Well, then that's acceptable. We're, okay.
Huh, I gotta get me an agent.
You're on, Mickey.
Thanks, boys! I have an announcement here. The duck formerly known as Donald is currently signing autographs in the lobby. Autographs?
He's super-duper duck-a-ribbic!
You said it!
Just a reminder, coming up after the next cartoon, the Three Caballeros! Oh, here's a cartoon Donald ought to watch!
Welcome back to Smarty Britches, the game show for smart people. Returning champion, Professor Ludwig von Drake. And new contestant, Mr. Goofy. Prepare for your final Smarty Britches quiz questions. The category, questions that Goofy could never answer in a million years.
Uh-oh.
First question, what is the elemental name of table salt?
Sodium chloride.
Correct. Second question, at what point of the year is the Earth...
Wow! Winter solstice.
Farthest away from the sun. Correct again, Professor. And the next question is...
What is psychic ability?
Correct! And that ends the game! Professor Ludwig von Drake, you're our reigning champion with a record $3 million! As for you, Mr. Goofy, you owe us $3 million!
Well, I don't got that kind of money!
Woo-wee! I'm rich and smart!
Heavens to Betsy, I want to be smart like him!
Well, there may be hope for you yet if you go back to school! Beginning with elementary school.
You're tiny.
Out of my way!
The school bell is the signal for students to take their seats. The bell also signals recess.
Whoa! Heavens to Betsy!
I said out of my way!
One skill certain to help one become smart is reading.
The Three Musketeers!
Shh!
Sorry.
The Three Musketeers.
Heavens to Betsy!
Of course, one must indulge in all the classics, such as A Farewell to Arms, or the masterpiece Moby Dick. Yes, being smart is synonymous with being well-read. Soon, the student advances to junior high school. A sure sign of smarts is one's ability to write, and the beginning writer is wise to choose a simple sentence.
I am smart. How about that?
The writer can bring more meaning to the sentence with the addition of an adverb.
I am not smart.
Hey!
A conjunction allows an additional sentence segment to be linked.
I am not smart and I smell. You little...
Don't be afraid to use other nouns as descriptors in your sentence.
I am not smart and I smell like a monkey. That's it!
Remember that sometimes the best sentence is the shortest.
Ouch.
Serious students must not overlook physical education, for all work and no play makes Jack a dull boy.
I don't know, Jack.
Basketball is among the favorite sports of the height advantaged.
Shorty.
For those not height advantaged, the dramatic effects of puberty can be of assistance.
Heavens to Betsy!
After junior high, it's time for high school. High school includes the student's greatest challenge, the dreaded higher mathematics.
All you have to do is add this roundabob to the whatchamacallit, the subtract to this thingy, which equals this here pointy-ma-jigger. Oops, forgot the decimal point. Heavens to Betsy! Stand still, would you?
Many students struggle with higher mathematics, but one must never forget the basics, such as subtraction, addition, division, and, of course, multiplication. You've done it, Intelligence Seeker. You've made it through school. And now you have a piece of paper that says, I'm smart. And it's time to put those smarts to the test with our Super Smarty Britches Jackpot Quiz Question. In the 1949 Ajax League World Series, what was the throw that made the final out?
Oh, boy. Oh, that's a toughie.
He doesn't know the answer? Heavens to Betsy!
That's correct!
Huh?
It was a throw from pitcher Tommy Heavens to second baseman Billy Betsy. Heavens to Betsy, Mr. Goofy, you're our new Smarty Britches champion!
I am!
As you can see, a student of higher learning is always victorious in the end. Now we'll just take back that $3 million you owe us.
Well, that's okay. I've still got my smarts and my britches.
Donald, the crowd wants the Three Caballeros. Panchito and José better show up soon.
Hola, Señor Mickey.
Hello again. It's great to see you again.
It's great to be here at the House of Mouse.
Gee, the crowd's been waiting all night for you guys. You think you can do something about him?
So, Donald thinks he's the star again, eh?
El Rodente, don't you worry, huh? We've got a song for him.
And now, the Three Caballeros.
Ay, 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 ay. Ay, 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 ay.
We love to sing and to dance and to jump up and down while we play lots of music. And we listen to everyone screaming our love for the Three Caballeros. Keep on shouting our names.
I'm Panchito!
José!
And we love to make music while we wiggle our hips and we dance and we say everybody. We love to sing and to dance and to jump up and down as we move to the music. Everyone get together and gather around
what we say!
We are the Three Caballeros. We love to sing and to play. You, Panchito, José. Clap your hands all together and let's hear you say Viva Three Caballeros!
We are the Three Caballeros. We are the Three Caballeros.
Sorry, Donald, but you asked for it, my friend.
This is true, amigo.
Besides, the House of Mouse loves your act. Listen.
Huh? Oh, I am a star.
You're my favorite caballero.
And don't you worry, Donald. I'll make sure everybody remembers you this time. Cue Mike.
Today's entertainment, courtesy of the Three Caballeros, featuring the duck formerly known as Donald. Enjoy all their foot-stomping salsa hits like Donald's Tail and Fuego, No Comprende Donald, and who can forget the Unca Donald Polka? The Three Caballeros' greatest hits.
Some Donald Duck lyrics may be unintelligible.
Thanks, Caballeros. Good night, folks. The mouse, currently known as Mickey, who will see you real soon.
Up next, a chance to catch another one of those alien genetic experiment cousins roaming loose on the island of Hawaii in Lilo and Stitch.
House of Mouse.